Good morning dear students, welcome back to our lesson, that is why do we fall ill. So yesterday we have seen students introduction of this lesson, and in that introductory part I have let you know various points related to our health. What happens when we fall ill, when we go to the doctor, how doctor is diagnosing us, how it's giving proper medication for us and asking us to take a proper care of our body. So this what is the long form of WHO? Again, what points are included later on after 30 years into the health, that we have seen in yesterday's topic. So today, our topic further, we will go ahead for the further topic. And the name of the today's topic is basic conditions required for the good health. Okay. So today's topic is basic conditions which are required for the good health. Students, yesterday also I said you, good health may different for the means may mean different things for the different people. See students, yesterday we have taken an example of a coal miner, or we can take any example of a laborer who is doing a labor work, means hard physical work when the person is doing, that is called as a laborer. If the coal miner, I have taken example of yesterday, so I would like to go with yesterday's example only. So for the coal miner who is working very hard, very hard physical work which is doing in the mine, coal mine, for according to that person, the good health means what? The proper physical fitness. If that person is proper physically fit, then it can perform its work regularly, it doesn't have any problem. So that according to the coal miner, physical fitness is more important. Okay, so according to the coal miner, physical health is most important. But at the same time, if we take example, the person who is working in an office, at that time the person has to deal with the various people, okay, and has to take various decisions. So that mental alertness means mental health is more important for the person who is working in an office. Here physical health not much important for the person who is working in an office like coal miner, understood? So mental alertness is more important for the person who is working in an office. So person to person, the meaning of good health may change, okay? But overall we can say good health, there are some basic conditions for the good health. See students, there is an old saying, yesterday also we have seen health is wealth, okay? Likewise, there is one old saying, that is sound mind in a sound body. See, this is also old saying of proverbs, sound mind in a sound body. This proverb also can explain you the importance of a good health in our day-to-day life. So there are some basic conditions which are required for the good health. Means if these conditions are not present, then it may affect on the individuals or the community health. So what are those basic conditions, students? What can you guess? What may be the first basic conditions to have a good health? Can you please explain me? Okay, I will like to let you know. Conditions for a good health. Conditions for good health. What are those conditions? The first very important condition for the good health is what? Balanced diet. Balanced diet. The second most important condition is what? Maintaining proper hygienic and sanitary conditions in the environment. Next is what? Providing good social and economical condition. Okay, next. There is a right to have everyone clean food. Clean food, clean air, and clean water too. This is the right. Okay, after it, which point will be coming? Fifth one.
That if the individual
healthy person. But at the same time, into the disease-free body, what happens? Only that person is not suffering from any disease. Okay, students? So disease-free body and the healthy body are quite different concept. Disease-free body means what? Means that person is only not suffering from any problem or any disease. That is only, or nothing else in there. But at the same time, healthy person's definition is little different. In healthy, all aspects are taken into account. But at the same time, in the disease-free body means only that person is not suffering from any disease. So we can include this point, one who is not suffering from any disease, and here you can write the definition of the health. Okay. The second is what? The disease-free body is related, but it refers to only individual. Means only personal health is included. If the person is not suffering from any disease, or disease-free body is only related to that individual. Okay? At the same time, healthy term is related to not only individual's body, at the same time, it affects on the community health. So this is also the second most difference, that it refers to individual as well as the community health. Okay? Now the third point. A disease-free body, a disease-free individual may have a good health or the poor health. A disease-free body, it may have a good health or the poor health. It's not necessary always that person would have poor health or the good health. It may have a poor health and the good health. Why? The healthy person can be normal under every condition, because the person is healthy, right? Mentally it is healthy. If there would be any problem, any stress, the person can deal with it. Understood? If there would be some any other problem, the person, because of the good immunity, the person can overcome that problem also. So in every condition, the healthy person will remain cool and calm and quiet. So these are some basic differences